实际上，在整个《内经》里面没有讲这样的阴阳平衡啊，绝对没有讲。我至少，我们朱老师，您是教《内经》，您在《内经》里面有这样的阴阳平衡的概念吗？我想是没有，因为《内经》有一个很重要的概念，这位老师提的很好。阴阳平衡，《内经》有一个概念叫做。
So however, in the Nei Jing, they never talk about the yin yang like this. The balance between the yin and yang in the classics, it's never that way, like in the modern textbooks. And he asked Kevin here, if he teaches the classic, if he read in the classics to the Nei Jing, he said, for sure not.
它有一个概念叫平人，平人我们可以理解为是平衡、阴阳平衡的人，可能过去我们的教材会这样去解释这个平人，而且。 这个是在《平人气象论》里面有一句话叫“平人者不病，平人者不病也”，就是说。So
in the Nei Jing, they have a quote or a sentence that, or a phrase. They said "平人." "平人" means like an even person, and they said "even" or a person who is even is not going to get sick. He will not get sick. So now we're explaining what it means.
就是什么样的人叫平人呢？ 平人者不病，就是平人是不会生病的人，也就是说健康。So
what is it called 平人? What is it called a person who is even, a person who can't get sick, a person who stays healthy?
也就是说，医学所要追求的这个目标实际上就是，如果我们用很简单的一个概念去定义这个健康。So
if you want to establish a definition, what is like to be healthy, this is what it is, an even person, that's what it means to be healthy.
那么内经里面就讲的是平人则不病，就是只要他是平，属于平人，那么他就是一个不病的人。那么换句话来说，什么是病的人呢？
So in the Nei Jing we said that even person is the one who will not get pregnant, the one who even person is a person who will not get sick. So what is a person that will get sick then?
你搞成你的本行了。那么就是说，非平人就病，就是生病的，对吧？
So the Nei Jing said if it's not 平人, if it's not even person, then he will get sick.
那现在我反过来跟大家商量，那么既然是这样一个，那么医生所做的工作是什么？So
then I
我们所做的工作。So
then I put it back to you and I said, then what is the job of the doctor then? In that case, if this is health, what is the job of the doctor? What should he do? Question.
Diagnose the person properly so that he can treat them efficiently.
就这个话题，就是说，平人是不病的人，那么反过来，非平人就是要生病的人。所以，那么医生所做的工作是什么？我是要您这个即刻的根据我刚刚讲您讲的那个没错，但是我要您根据我现在讲的这个话题来回答。
So you said what you just said is not wrong, but we just want to follow what we're talking about now. Meaning, if you're an even person, you don't get sick. If you're not even, then you will get sick. So according to this way of thinking, what should the doctor do? Like, talking about this kind of thing.
就是把人带回到平的状态。嗯，他看看。Like,
if even person is not sick, not even person is sick, then what is our job?
To get the person even.
Right, 我们要。<coughs>
就是说，实际上医生做的事情没有其他，就是使不平重新回到平。There's
nothing else for our Chinese medicine doctor but to put the person back into this even state, this balanced state.
而这个平人，并不是说阴一半阳一半的情况叫做平，实际上自然不是这样。 自然几乎没有这样的状态，对吧？那么这个平人指的是什么呢？是没有太过也没有不及的人，他叫平人。
So when we talk about this even person, in nature, this is not, does not mean half and half. This is not even. When we talk about even person, it means not too much and not too little, not excessive and not deficient. It's not really that it has to be equal half and half.
那什么叫做没有，什么叫做太过，什么叫做不及呢？那我们应该，学中医那么长时间，应该知道。
So what is it called too much or too little? For us, we studied for so long. I'm sure we know what it is.
在这个《内经》里面，他提到了这个什么叫做太过了，就叫做。
为智而智叫做太过，智而不智叫做不及。就为智而智，就是还没有到来，就是说我们今天是
9 o'clock 上课 class， 就是，那么你8:30就来了，就叫太过了。你迟到了，我们上课了已经9:30，你才。 你才酸酸来吃啊，咬一根面包，一个巧克力才，这就不及了。那么这《内经》的太过不及是这样一个意思。So
in the Neijing, they explain what is this too much or too little or not enough. It's called, there's a sentence that said, if it needs to get there but it's not there yet, it's called not enough. If it shouldn't get there but it's already there, it's too much. So then. We explain, for example, when you come to class today, should be here at 9 o'clock. But if you came here already at 8:30, it's too much. But if you just went outside and you ate breakfast and you took your time and you came here at 9:30, it's not enough. That's how the Neijing explain what is not enough or too much.
这是一个非常重要一个问题，就是这个太过不及这个概念。 也是实际上跟我们昨天讲到的逆从，它是一个相匹配的一个概念。This
concept of not enough or too much is an extremely important concept in the Neijing, and it accompanies what we talked about yesterday about the going against the flow or following the heaven. So these two concepts complement each other.
您说的这个智啊，智啊，对对，说的智。 这个字就是到来的意思，这个字。这个标准的字是冬至的字。是冬，是跟四季有。啊，对，这个标准呢是什么呢？就是气。
So we're just asking, what is this character 字 that you talk? Sometimes it's hard to know which one just from saying, so he writes it.
这个标准就是气。这个在六节藏象论里面，六节藏象论里面，那么有一段很精彩的对话，就是。 大家学习过六节藏象论就知道了。那么皇帝就问岐伯，愿闻何谓气？就是皇帝就说啊，就是说这个我很想知道什么叫做气，然后岐伯就跟他说了：“此上帝所密，先师传之也。”就是此上帝所密。So
in
上帝。
One of the chapters of the Neijing is called the six sections and the storage of qi discussion. The Yellow Emperor asked his qibo, he said, what is qi? So qibo answered, qi is
上帝所密，就上帝这个密就是保密的意思，就是不轻易传出来的一个东西，然后先师传之也，就是我的先师传授给我。 那么也就是说，这个气是一个很重要的一个问题，连上帝都不轻易的泄露出来的一个问题。那么，他的启伯的先师，就是秘密传授给他的一个东西，是上帝所密先师这个传之也。So
he answers that this qi is a secret that he received from his teacher.
那么这个时候，皇帝就是很想知道他的具体、他的详细的情况啊。那么这个时候，岐伯就回答 什么叫做气呢?